Since he came out of the West to team with David Brinkley back in 1956, Chet Humphrey has been our competitor, and what a competitor. But he also is a colleague and a good friend. Tonight, over on that other network, as we say, he's saying goodnight to David for the last time on their evening newscast, returning to his native Montana to build a resort, and I suspect perhaps to get involved in politics. As he leaves the daily broadcast scene, a giant departs the stage. For journalism and for ourselves, we hate to see him go. But that's the way it is. Friday, July 31st, 1970. Goodbye, Chet.
Bye and good luck, Walter.
Direct from our newsroom in New York, in color, this has been the CBS Evening News with Walter Cronkite.
And so, this difficult moment is here. In leaving this post after almost 14 years, I recommend to you the NBC Nightly News, which begins tomorrow. It'll be in the most capable hands of David, John Chancellor, and Frank McGee. I'll be watching with interest and affection. I might also remind you that American journalism, all of it, is the best anywhere in the world. I want to thank the entire staff of NBC, for this nightly broadcast has not been an individual effort by any means. And as for you out there, I thank you first for your patience, then for your many kindnesses and the flattering things you have said and written. More difficult to take, to be sure, has been your criticism, but that too has been helpful and in most cases valid. But you have bolstered my conviction that this land contains an incredible quality and quantity of good common sense. And it's in no danger of being led down the primrose path by a journalist. At the risk of sounding presumptuous, I would say to all of you, be patient and have courage, for there will be better and happier news one day if we work at it. And David, thanks for these years of happy association. And for being such an easy colleague to work with, and for all the kindnesses.
Chet, I too would like to thank all of those who tune us in and put up with us, particularly including those who write the nasty letters. McGee and Chancellor and I will be here every night, and we'll miss you. Last night, NBC had a dinner for Chet and gave all of us a chance to say goodbye to him, and as a farewell gift, NBC gave him a horse. So, Chet, when you ride away to the West, to Montana, on your new horse, I will have to admit to at least a mild envy. And when you're out there under clear skies and clean air, maybe once in a while you will think of those of us still here, fighting the traffic, the transportation breakdowns, strikes, pollution, and wondering what is left that we can eat, drink, smoke, or breathe that will not kill us. And wondering what horror will be visited upon us next. In these years, I have often been stopped in public by people, polite, who knew I was either Huntley or Brinkley, but weren't sure which. And so they would ask, well, from now on, when somebody stops me in the street and says, aren't you Chet Huntley? I have an answer. It is no, ma'am. He is the one out west on the horse. I really don't want to say it, but the time has come. And so, for the last time, good luck. And good night, Chet.
Good luck, David. And good night for NBC News.